Hello and welcome to my channel. I am Savita. In today's video, I am going to show you one of my favorite DIY projects. I made this ethnic look wall hanging a year back for myself and later decided to sell it. I got huge response to buy this wall hanging. This is an easy DIY project which can be done to your desired size. I'm using this redwood bender board for this project. You can find this in Home Depot. In some Home Depot it is in lumber section and in some Home Depot it is in the garden section. So it is better to ask people working there before searching for it. So this bender board comes in two different lengths, 12 feet and 8 feet. Since my car cannot hold 12 feet bender boards, I bought 8 feet one. One thing you should remember to do before loading this bender boards into your car, tap it very nicely on the ground to remove the sawdust stick to it. Anyway, you need to vacuum your car after coming home. So now let us go into the video and see how to make this wall hanging. The reason why I have choose this board is because it is very lightweight and is easy to handle and work with. The finished product is not very heavy and can be easily wall mounted without any worry about the weight. The second reason is that it costs lesser compared using other type of boards. You can see lots of sawdust sticking to these bender boards. Before buying these bender boards, carefully examine each board for proper edges and wood deformities. Each board is around 3.3 inches wide and 96 inches long, and for today's project I need 4 such boards. I have cut each plank to roughly 3 equal pieces of around 32 inches each. I will need 11 pieces. You can customize the width and height you desire and purchase the boards accordingly. Cutting is very easy and you can use handsaw or jigsaw. If you don't have either saws, you can have it cut to the desired length at Home Depot itself for an extra fee that they charge. I have sanded one side of the plank for smoother look and sanded the back side just to remove the sawdust that sticks to the board. Since this board is very thin, I recommend you not to sand too much. We also need 3 pieces common wood for back support. The boards come in 8 feet length and are 3 inches wide and 1 inch thick. Cut this common wood to the desired length depending on the height of the wall hanging. Once all pieces are ready, I'm going to stain this using wood stain. I'm using dark walnut color. Using a piece of sponge or a rag, apply the stain on one side of all the planks and the wooden board. Don't forget to apply well on all the edges, as otherwise it spoils the look when you look at the sides. Also, use a pair of gloves to protect your hands from the stain. I got a helping hand from my younger daughter to stain these boards. Though the common wood is for back support, it has to be stained because when we arrange these redwood boards on it, there will be fine gaps between the boards. And if the common wood is not stained, it will appear through the gaps in a different color. Allow the stain to completely dry once you are done with staining. Now the stain has dried and it's time to arrange the planks and nail it. When we nail the redwood boards to the common board, there is a high chance that the common board moves and changes position. To avoid this, I'm going to tape this double-sided tape on this carton to hold the common board in position. Now place these boards on either sides and in the middle. Make sure that they are equally spaced from each other. Before nailing the redwood boards, first place them on the common board and ensure that all the boards are correctly positioned and the final appearance is correct.
I want the top and bottom boards to extend out about half an inch from the back common board. So before cutting the common board, consider this and take the measurement. I'm aligning the redwood boards with a slight offset in a zigzag fashion. But if you want it to be perfect shape square rectangle, you can arrange them accordingly. Now using the wire brad nails, fix these redwood boards to the three common board at the back. I want to share a short story about how I built my first wall hanging and sold it. As I had mentioned in one of my earlier videos on home entryway tour, I don't hesitate to pick up stuff from curbside if I feel that it has potential. During one such trip, I found a few wooden planks that were of good length, already clean, sanded, and appeared new on the curbside. At that time, I did not know what it was called. The color and the grains on the wood were so attractive that I immediately picked them. I guess someone discarded their leftover bender boards after a project. After returning home, I was checking for ideas in Pinterest. I got lot many ideas, but many of them were using different types of wood that were very heavy. I have picked one such idea and wanted to give a try with these boards. It came out very beautiful and I was able to sell it. After that very first sale, I got many orders from interested folks, but I still did not know what it was called, where to purchase them, or how much it might cost. I spent at least a week on the internet to find its name and still couldn't find the name. Finally, I took a leftover piece to Home Depot and asked one of the experienced staff in the lumber section, and he recognized the board by name and guided me to the section that I could find them. So don't hesitate to ask for help from Home Depot staff. Most of them are very helpful. Back to the project in hand now. Once you have nailed all the planks, test the firmness of each board by giving a slight shake. If required, hammer additional nails. Now the construction part is over. For stenciling, I am going to use the color Peacock from Waverly and this mandala stencil. I want to give it a rustic feel before stenciling, so I am using a dry brush technique to get that effect. Take a very small amount of paint in the brush, remove excess and very lightly brush it on the planks in one direction. If you feel that the paint is more in some part, just spray some water and remove it using a rag. Once this is complete, we can start stenciling the motifs. I'm going to center the stencil for the top 6 planks and using the stencil brush, paint the design on the plank. This wall hanging is a rustic look one, and not all planks that we are using are of same thickness. Since the surface is not perfectly level, stenciling the motifs won't be perfect. That is totally fine. For a rustic look, perfection doesn't matter. I'm using the same stencil for the motifs on the bottom portion. Using this border stencil, I am painting the borders on either side. I like using these brass thumbtack nails for an ethnic look, so I am nailing them on the design patterns. I'm not using the thumbtack here because this is where I will fix this diya. Before screwing this diya, I want to give a protective coat for the paint and place some hoops on the back side that will be used for hanging the piece on the wall. I usually give clear wax for a work of this kind, but this time I wanted to try this water-based polyurethane.
I was worried how the look will turn out once the polyurethane has dried. I'm happy with the final appearance. One thing I realized is that the polyurethane coat is making the thumbtack look dull. So if you make this, remember to apply the polyurethane coat before nailing the thumbtack. Now I'm flipping the plank to its back to nail the sawtooth hooks to hang this on the wall. I'm measuring 2 inches from the top on either side on the common board. Make sure that you are measuring from the top edge. The nails that comes with the sawtooth hoop is very small. I'm using a longer nail so that it holds stronger. Now it is in its final stage. I'm going to hang this diya here. I bought this on Amazon. Fixing this diya needs the correct type of screw. The screw should not be very long and the head of the screw should be big enough so that the diya will not fall off. You can hang any brass piece or even skip this step. It is up to you. Once I have screwed, I'm going to cover the screw head using a thumbtack. For this, I have removed the nail part of the thumbtack and stuck the head of the thumbtack over the screw head using E6000 glue. You can also use hot glue. It's all done now. A beautiful ethnic look wall hanging is ready in a very low budget. This will give a very welcoming appearance in your entryway. Instead of blue, you can also try this in red or white colors depending on other color theme in your house. So don't hesitate to give it a try. If I can do it, you also can. I will be happy to see your work. For more ideas, watch other videos in my channel. Please subscribe and press the bell icon for notification. Thanks for watching.